I'm Rui Barroso, welcome back to Tango Online. And today, continuing our analysis of the rhythmical structure of tango, we'll be talking about the power of the weak. And by power of the weak, I mean all the potential that the weak beats give us in the interpretation of the music. The truth is that usually we use the weak beats just as a means to accelerate. So we go from a strong, strong into a strong, weak, strong, weak, strong. So usually we use the weak beats just as a means to this end or to this goal of moving faster. But the truth is that there's much more. There's much more we can do if we learn the potential of the weak beat in the music. Why? Well, let's say that the weak beat are not always weak. Sometimes, for example, the weak beats are actually strong as the first and the third beats of the bar of music. So sometimes I ran out of reds and blues, so we have greens and yellows. So usually sometimes in the song what we have is this. We have the first is strong, but then the second is also strong, the third and the fourth. So there's not really a big change how they are emphasized by the orchestra. So you feel them all as strong beats. Other times you have, and sometimes when they are all strong, you feel that they are all equally strong and in the same melody and you feel really no difference. And other times they are equally emphasized, but in different ways. So you will feel these two as strong, and you will listen to something in the music, and you will feel these two as strong, but you will listen to it in a different way. So there's a slight difference between these two, even though they are all strong. Okay. Another possibility, we knew that this is the most common one. Okay. But what we have, for example, this would be a Di Sarli style. But then you have Pugliesi, which takes this even deeper, the difference between the strong beats and the weak beats. It's like if the weak become even weaker, so they fade away, you almost don't listen to them, but you still do listen to them, they are still there, and these two become really, really emphasized. So there's a bigger change, a bigger difference between these two beats and these two beats, okay? And then you have another possibility, which is when you don't listen to any weak beats at all, so you just listen to the strong beats. And in this case, what you have is actually a marcato in dos, so you only feel two beats each bar of music, okay? Now, let's listen to all these possibilities in the music and let's see if I can make this more clear by showing you some examples. So the first example would be this. In the tango in the end of the 20s and during the 30s, most of the songs were actually had a lot of this mood of having the four beats equally emphasized. So in this case, Derecho Viejo from 1927, Canaro, and you can actually feel this quite clearly. Look. So they are, the four of them are equally strong, okay? The same happens already in 1950, but the Arienzo style, what you have is this, is the same idea. Yeah, so there's not really a weak beat. Now, when you listen, when you compare, for example, D'Arienzo and Di Sarli, D'Arienzo seems faster. But the truth is that what Di Sarli does is this, no? So by creating this difference between these two and these two, it kind of drives you to walk mostly on these two and to use from time to time the weak beats. But D'Arienzo does something different. By emphasizing the four, it's like it's driving you to use all the four beats every time in each bar of music. So we tend to dance faster, not because the music is necessarily faster, but because all the beats are equally emphasized, so we try to use them all. So we are always stepping almost four steps each bar of music instead of only two, like in this early. In order for the music to actually be faster, independently of how they are emphasized, the bar of music would be a bit shorter like this. Sometimes it happens, of course, but it's not only this reason that makes the music goes faster. Actually, it's the fact that the weak beats are emphasized as much as the strong beats, okay? Now, another possibility was the immediate, the opposite, which is when you don't listen at all the weak beats, so you have the marcato in dos, so you only listen to the strong beats. So here you have a marcato in quattro, equally emphasized. Now look at the difference. It changed back to marcato in quattro, equally emphasized, and it changes. Yeah? Okay, good. So, there are many examples of this. For example, in Chique, for example, you have the same. From Troilo also. Changed back to marcato in quattro. Okay, good. So I hope this is clear. Now another possibility would be to listen to the, to have a bit the same idea, which is all the beats are emphasized but not exactly in the same way, so you can feel a difference between these two and these two. This happens quite clearly in Viviani from this early, an instrumental. So let me... So let's see what happens with the strong beats. Look. The first and the third. Now let's listen to the same moment and let's focus on these two. Yes, of course you can then also use them all because they are all emphasized, so you could do something like... Good. Okay, so this is another possibility. Now, in the same song, for example, in the beginning, what we have is a small moment where these two disappear. What we have is this. There's a moment where the first and the third become weak and the second and the fourth become strong. This happens only in one bar of the music. So let's try to get this. Let's see if I can change it in time. So something like this. Yes? Again. So, this would be the first of the bar of music, no? And then it goes back to normal, so... Yes? Okay. So... This would be the other alternative, and then you have, for example, in songs like D'Arienzo, for example, also, you have this, where the emphasized beats are actually the second and the fourth. This comes as an exception, but in this particular song, this happens quite a lot. Look. Yes. Yes, so that's why some songs are quite hard to dance, because unless you learn how to dance on the weak beat, you can never get this, you will always be out of the music in a way. You will always be walking on the strong beat, where you actually don't listen to the strong because we are listening to the weak. So it's important to control the possibility of using the weak beats. Another good example of this is Didi from Di Sarli. This previous one was Ella Pronte from D'Arienzo. And now in here... Here is normal, no? So these are now the strong. Okay, so basically these are all the possibilities, but there's something extra that I want to share with you, which is the possibility to actually walk on the weak beats even though the song doesn't emphasize them. So you would be walking on the silence. And this, if you do it without intention, we could say that you are offbeat, you are not listening to the music, you are wrong, you cannot get the strong beat. But if you intend to do this, which is, I really want to walk on the silence, I want to walk in between strong beats, this can be quite exquisite. In your interpretation of the song. It's like emphasizing what you are doing specifically because you are going against the music. So you are creating this contrast, which in the end kind of brings value to what you are doing in that moment. No? So it creates tension, or if you prefer, attention to what you are doing. So let's, for example, listen to this song. Also, if you do this, if you start using the weak beats, imagine that you decide to walk to step here, which is the weak beat. But sometimes some instruments, they start playing in the middle of the song and they don't necessarily enter on the first beat of the bar. The piano very often starts, for example, on the second beat of the bar, even though this one is the strong, the piano starts here. So if you are actually walking on these two in what is the silence, you eventually end up catching the beginning of the piano, which kind of can become very interesting. Let's see this in this song, for example. The same will happen with the violin. Yes, so yeah, I think that's it for today. I hope this helps. Stay tuned, because there's a lot more to talk about concerning tango music. And so keep practicing, and we see each other next week. Cheers.